let's start to see how the design tool works. So let's log in with our account. Okay, and just to see, to get familiar with the interface, we're going to open an existing project. So I'm going to click here, open project. Open project from the online database. So I'm going to click here. You can grab any project from this tab, tutorial projects. These are free to download by anyone. So I'm going to go here and download this one. Okay, just so that we can see, get familiar with the program in general. You can see here on top, we have a main menu with the usual options. So for example, file where we can save, we can open a new project. We have some export in various formats for our project. We have some view settings for the program. We saw some of these earlier, general settings of the program, language, if you want to change the language, help and feedback. Just below this main menu, we have these work tabs. These are create room, place objects, layout tiles, where we can manage our tiling, and then onto the render to get the photorealistic results of our design. We can skip from one tab to the other to work on different aspects of our design. So for example, on create room, we're going to create the drawing, and then on place objects, we can drag and drop some products in our room and place them where we need. On layout tiles, we can create the floorings and coverings and place them on our surfaces. And then on the main toolbar here, you see there are lots of different icons. Each one of these is a different tool. You will notice that while you move from one tab to another, some of these tools become active. For example, these ones here are active now. If we move on place objects, you will see these tools are not active anymore. But for example, if we choose, if we select an object from the 3D view, you will see these tools now available to use. We will see all of those in the next videos. What's most important for now is to get familiar with the 2D view that you see here and the 3D view that you see here on the right, and in some tabs you also see in full screen. So in the 2D view, first of all, we can use the mouse scroll to zoom in and zoom out. If we keep the mouse scroll pressed and we move the mouse around, we can move this 2D sheet to move somewhere else. If we select a different surface in our project, this view will change, and then we can work on it here on the 2D view on the left. We're just going to go on place objects because this is where we find a full screen 3D view. On the 3D view, we also use the mouse scroll to zoom in and zoom out. Here instead, we keep the right click of our mouse pressed and move it around so that we can rotate the view in this way, as if we were rotating our head. And then also here below, we have some icons, for example, move left, move right, move up, and so on. If we keep our mouse on top of these icons, you see each one of those has a corresponding keyboard shortcut. So for example, we can move left by pressing A, we can move right by pressing D, we can move up by pressing Q, and we can move down by pressing Z. This is exactly, for example, how video games work. You can use your left hand on the keyboard to move the view, and at the same time, you can use your right hand to rotate or zoom in and zoom out. So before you continue, you might want to take some time to practice with using both the keyboard and mouse together. so that you can fluently move inside of your projects and get anywhere you need in order to then work in your designs.